spoke with President Xi yesterday. They very much want to make a deal. I think we'll make a deal with China, and I think it'll be a very fair deal for everybody, but it will be a good deal for the United States.
And that was enough to lift stocks off their lows. So, folks, what do you make of all this?
Okay.
Well, I'll jump in. There's a couple things. One is it's curious that these tariffs, which amount to a total on our economy, a 0.2% on GDP, can move the markets. The other thing I still scratch my head. We know that, quote unquote, the FANG stocks are the market movers, Facebook, you know, Amazon, Netflix. And it's ironic, those stocks are not even affected by the tariffs. Even Apple is exempt. So you look at the market movers, why would the market be down on tariff news, good or bad, when the majority of the stocks moving the market aren't even affected? That said, I'm bullish that there's going to be something that's going to be done, just like there was with NAFTA. Maybe even Trump will have an Election Day surprise.
Ooh.
I mean, look,
tariffs, wow. Tariffs are bad economics. This isn't up for debate, David. I mean, Henry Hazlitt proved this. Adam Smith proved this. This is not up for debate. And this might end up being like George Bush Sr., where tariffs, steel and aluminum tariffs were tried very early in Bush Sr.'s administration. They found that it didn't work, and they quickly lifted them. And ultimately, Bush went on to some success in that realm. But, I mean, tariffs are taxes. The sooner we can get rid of the taxes, the better for every American, certainly every American business person.
Well, Gary B., I'll point out that those FANG stocks, all of them, are now in correction territory or even bear market territory, down 10 or even 20% in some cases, number one. And the question about Apple, you bring up Apple and China. Apple is not subject to the tariff fight yet, but people are looking toward the end of the year and thinking, well, you know what, who's next? Apple and their iPhone imports, and then what is China going to do to retaliate against Apple in the Chinese market, critical growth area, and what will it do to retaliate against the manufacturing
complex? I'm not going to let you guys all pile up
China.
On my old bulls and bears friend Gary. He's bringing up some very interesting points, notably these tariffs just aren't that much of a big deal yet. Okay, yeah, theoretically in the past there's been some tariff issues, but that was during the Great Depression and those were very significant tariffs. Yeah. That
and
was
this
before
time
the internet.
It's different.
That was before global supply chains. There are tariffs now all over the place. They ship cars into other countries and then take them apart and reassemble them to avoid all the idiocy in the market.
Exactly.
It's not like there's this pure free market that Trump's messing up. It's totally screwed up now. Does that mean the market wouldn't go down if we were in a recession and the tariff war escalated? But the levels of tariffs we're at now, which is pretty low, even if they expand to your holy iPhone, is not going to trigger a market crash. The financial media overplays this tariff thing. The interest rate moves recently back up to 3.25 are way more impactful to stocks, to the economy, than the trade battle, even though that gets all the press.
Jonas and I are in complete agreement. This whole because we've had a little bit of a sell-off, companies are now running to hide behind this tariff story, just like they do when the retailers say, oh my gosh, we were affected by the hurricane, as if no one ever shopped for clothing before or after that. So this whole tariff story, as Jonas points out, we're not even sure we can collect all the tariffs,
Gary,
out there. There's so many workarounds,
at
shipping
one point,
from third-party countries.
I remember you as being a price
guy.
Hold
on 1 second. I think it's a cover story for companies that have bad earnings or revenue misses due to some other factor.
I thought you were someone who was interested in price trends and looking at those long-term trends. You know, whatever it is, I'm seeing. I have to put me on the bear.
I am, but it can't be attributed to the tariffs.
Well, you know, when 2008 really started, it started in 2007, and people thought it was just a subprime issue. So we don't know what ultimately causes a market maelstrom. But what worries me is that the news is so good, but so many stocks are doing so poorly, David, especially corporate debt. We haven't seen junk bonds and high-yield bonds, corporate bonds selling off as much as we've ever seen
before.
But,
you know, there is news out there that there may actually be a draft agreement between China and the administration. The administration, some of them are denying that's true. Larry Kudlow said no, but maybe they are really getting somewhere for all the talk, for all the threats, for all the tariffs. If they end up with a deal, that ain't a bad thing.
these 200-point swings you're talking about aren't a lot anymore. That used to be a big deal. Yeah, they can be. Trump comes out and says some tariff stuff. The market goes up, it goes down. But you're talking about a situation where it is just not that much of a deal in this economy. Now, does that mean people can't panic and cause the, you can panic about everything. But the bottom line is these tariffs are small. He's not doing 50, 80, 90% tariffs. Mm-hmm. It's a small tariff. Look, they've got 20% value added taxes across Europe. Germany's economy is okay. You can have a tariff forever if it's low and it doesn't lead to distortions and factories being relocated and all this other junk.
It's already happening, though.
I'm not saying it's a good thing, but just because it's not a good thing doesn't mean it's going to cause the next depression. That is overblowing the risk of a trade war. And it's why we are in a weak position.
Since I'm
can't
the only
negotiate
chef
China,
on the show,
because
can
China's
I please,
been...
please talk here? I mean, you stopped me before my sentence ended with a period. To Gary B's point, but Gary B, this market is weak in terms of, look at the revenue misses that we've seen so far in this quarter. You've had more than 40% of companies, I think, based on the latest data, that missed revenue expectations. Earnings, right. You can juice. You can cut costs. Yay, you got a tax cut. But ultimately, you need to grow the revenue, and the revenue's been the problem, whether you were talking about the revenue forecast for Apple, for Amazon. That's what's whacked those stocks so badly.
What are you talking about the revenue miss? Are you talking about for like the National Railroad Company and,
no.
and consolidated coal miners? Who cares about those companies? Stocks that are on the forefront are killing it. Amazon, Google, Apple are killing it.
What about Gary? What about
revenue by 30%?
Yeah, but Facebook's at a 52-week low. Amazon is in a bear market, 20% off the highs. I mean, look.
Yeah, that's this.
Take the politics out. Just look at the price. Yeah. Is this a bullish or bearish stock market?
Look, in 2000,
I am looking at the price.
The revenues are very good too. Before the market fell 50%,
down from its highs, it's still in a bull market.
All right, and let me just switch a little bit to Main Street from Wall Street, because we got those incredible jobs numbers today. 250,000 jobs created in October, way over expectations. So Main Street is backing up Wall Street.
That was very, very good news for an election, and it's great news for the economy. But from a stock market point of view, you know, remember when Donald Trump said you're going to get tired of so much winning. Investors are getting tired of so much winning. The problem is when unemployment's this low and you just saw a big wage gain, we didn't see wage gains like that during the Obama administration. It starts to build on the problem of, wait a second, interest rates are going higher. Top line revenues are slowing, maybe not for everybody, but our expectations were for much higher growth. And now we have to start paying people more. This is not a great environment for investors. And that is ultimately why stocks, particularly tech stocks, are going down.
Not tariffs. You're worried about the Federal Reserve raising.
Didn't we have the same environment in the mid-90s when wages were growing up, inflation was creeping up a little? That was a great time for investors.
When interest rates went up very fast, I believe in 93, it was very bad for the stock market briefly because it happened too quickly, and that's what it looked like when we were heading to 3.25%. And today, we got back up to 3.2 on the 10-year, and that's where the problem started a few weeks ago when we went fast up to 3.25. I'm sure we can be backed up on that chart by...
David, what I hear you saying is that the economy is doing well and that the consumer is confident. This is true, and this is nothing to be besmirched. But historically, that tends to occur at market tops. And Gary B, and we were all there. We remember that enthusiasm was very high in 2000, and people were very optimistic. This is a lagging indicator.
Remember, it also happened in 1984 when the economy grew by 7.3%. It also happened in 1985 and 1986 when the economy was growing over 4% a year.
I don't know. Gary had me at the beginning of the show, and now I'm starting to change over to Jonathan. He's making a good point about 2000-era fears. I got to tell you.
I'm optimistic, and I'm glad when people are making more money.